Hi there. I've been asked a few questions via Twitter as to how exactly I sharpen a knife using some toothpaste and a leather belt. So I thought I'd do a short video just to show everybody how it's done, and that should hopefully answer a load more of the questions. So what I've got a leather belt. Okay, this is one I've used previously. Showed it in my previous video with a little bit of toothpaste on it. I'll show you how to put toothpaste on in the first place. And go through the entire process with it. With some toothpaste, I've got a sharp knife, I've got a DC4, but I'll show you what I'm going to use that for in a second, and I've got a bit of paper. Now, just to show you that the knife is sharp to start off with, there you go. Now, as I was saying beforehand, I tell my knife to be sharp and it can cut some very hairline bits off, and hopefully you can still see that. Okay, you can see all the little hairline bits on there. So that shows you how sharp the knife is to start off with. I'm just going to trim this bit of paper off. Okay, so I'll put that to the side. I'll show you how sharp or blunt it is in a minute or two. Now, I said I've got a DC4, and this is what it's for. It's not for sharpening the knife up, it's for doing the bit that's going to hurt me. Take the DC4, hold it against my knife, and blunt it. Now, that paper back again. It's nowhere near as sharp as it was. A little bit there, but you can still see it's a awful lot dumber. Okay? Using toothpaste and a leather strop isn't for taking a knife and being completely dull. It's from taking it from being a little bit sharp and putting the finishing edge on there. Okay? So, I'll tidy away all this stuff here just now. Give myself a bit of a cleaner base to work from. You take your leather belt, or your leather strop, or whatever you want to use, it's made of leather. And on most things leather, you've got a smooth surface, and you've got a rough surface. I like to use the rough surface, okay? I just think it gives me a bit more of a grip of the polishing compound to get caught in, and then I can sharpen things up a bit better. Some people will use the smooth side. I'll use that for finishing off, but for actually getting the edge in the first place, I use the rough side on it. And then, for putting the toothpaste on, find a bit of your belt that doesn't have any ethanol on it already. Take a little bit of toothpaste, like that. White stuff does work better than many kind of gels or anything else, but it can be used. And just rub that into the leather. Okay? Like so. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you a different camera angle of that happening as well. Okay? So there you go, that's it. Just rub it in like that. Okay, keep it all nice and tight in like that. Okay, now as you see it's a bit kind of sticky. You want that to dry out completely, okay? This is one here that I done last night, still a little bit tacky, okay? And that's one I've been using for a long period of time. There's a bit of toothpaste on it and you can hear it's really hard, okay? So you want it to be like that, as hard as you can get it like that. Alright, so what you would do, that one's still a bit tacky yet, so we'll use this one. What you do is you take the knife, hopefully you can all see this okay. On the knife, we'll see if I can show you that on the camera, you should be seeing some little bits on the edge there shining. I don't know if you can see that or not. See if I can lift this up a little bit and show you. Can you see that shining in the light just there? Okay. All those shiny bits, that's the dull spots, so you can see how dull this knife is from start. And all you do is you start it on the point and run away from your fingers and towards the handle. Like that. Start on the point and run in. And you just keep doing that for a long period of time. Now, you can just do it as much as you can, like so. And this is as fast as I would normally do this. You want to be doing this probably about 300 to 400 times for an edge as blunt as this knife is, and it will give you a nice sharp edge on it. So what I'm going to do, rather than boring you for doing this all that time, I'll cut the camera off, I'll continue doing it, and I'll get back to you again once I've finished it. Okay? Okay. been doing this for quite some time now. Let's see how we're getting on, shall we? Now, I don't know if you can see this or not, so hopefully you can. We're getting there with it. Okay, that's about 100 times per side, and we're getting this, a carbon blade as well, so we're getting there with it. So I'm going to keep going just as I have been, and I'll show you exactly how I'm getting on with it once we finish off. Okay, I'll get you back again then. Well, there we go, that should be about 300 now, or thereabouts. I've been doing this for about 5-6 minutes, maybe more, so let's see how we're getting on with that now. Okay, hopefully you can see this okay. Alright. Now that's not bad at all there, is it? A sharp knife with toothpaste. See if I can get some of these thick, fine bits I was talking about beforehand. Again, I'm so fine I'm cutting the things off. Let's see. Trying to use the whole knife to create it, you see. Now, what I'll do is, I don't know if you can see these or not. Let me see. There's a really fine one there. I'm not sure, let's see if I can get it standing up right. Not sure if you can see that or not, but there's a really, really fine one just at the front there. Just, let me get a knife and I'll show you. Just right here. Right there. Okay. That's how fine I've been getting these cuttings coming off, so the knife is pretty sharp. If I zoom it back out again, and try doing all this, you can see it cuts all the way through. And there's all these little bits as well that I've been shaving off. Some of them are absolutely tiny. You see them against the point of the knife. So, that's it. That's how you sharpen a knife using toothpaste and leather. So, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my Twitter page. Don't forget to subscribe to YouTube as well. And please, leave me some comments. Thank you. See you later. Bye.